Give him one coming with a bit more josh. 5 minutes inshallah with Allah. Narai Takbir! Narai Risalat! Jashnay Miladun Nabi!
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمد عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه العزيز أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا هو خير مما يجمعون وقال النبي المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم يصف حقيقة نفسه أنا عند الله في أم الكتاب لخاتم النبيين وآدم منجلد في طينته وأنبئكم بتأويل ذلك دعوة أبي إبراهيم وبشارة عيسى قومه ورؤيا أم التي رأت أنه خرج منها نور أضاءت له قصور الشام وكذلك أمهات النبيين يرين أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى تشريفا لحبيبه صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. After praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and sending peace and salutations upon the pride of existence, our Master, our Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I'd like to, first of all, thank the one who carries the standard of Mawlana Bahauddin Naqshband radiallahu ta'ala, the one who bears the name of Shaykh Ahmad Farooqi Sirhindi radiallahu ta'ala, our Shaykh al-Murshid, Sayyidina Shaykh Khwaja Sufi Riyad Ahmad al-Naqshbandi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prolong his life and allow us to benefit from his presence. We'd like to extend our gratitude and thank everybody for making the effort to come today. This auspicious gathering concerns the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the urs of the one who linked us to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Grand Shaykh Rahmatullahi alayhi is a very difficult person to describe because of his great qualities. But we find a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which describes him entirely. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ مِنْ أَشَدْهُ أُمَّتِي لِي حُبًّا نَاسٌ يَكُونُونَ بَعْدِي يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ رَآنِي لِأَهْلِهِ وَمَالِهِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, the most in love with me from my ummah, people who will come after me. Each one of them, they will sacrifice everything they possess from their children and family and wealth just to see me once. Grand Shaykh embodied that. But his karama was that he could impart that love and yearning he had in his heart into his body. Hence you're here today celebrating the Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have this issue every year from a long time. The Munkirun, the people who deny the celebration of the Mawlid and these gatherings, they have a standard, they have a cornerstone, a yardstick. They say, well, is there anything in the hadith? Is there anything from the acts of the Sahaba? Or is there anything from the acts of the Tabi'in proving the celebration of the Mawlid of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We said yes, but you're hiding it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in His glorious book, say, O beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam, let everybody celebrate the bounty and the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if they do that, it's better than everything they amass from the world and the akhirah. That's one moment of celebration. They said, okay, that means Islam and Iman. We said, okay, let's look at the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because if you find something the Sahaba do it, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commends it, and he approves of it, it becomes an act of Sharia. Sayyidina Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, إِنَّ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ خَرَجَ عَلَى حَلْقَةٍ يَعْنِي مِنْ أَصْحَابِهِ. One day the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was walking past his Sahaba who was seated in a circle. And he stopped them and he said, مَا أَجَلَسَكُمْ? What is it that makes you sit here today? And they said, جَلَسْنَا نَدْعُ اللَّهَ وَنَحْمَدُهُ أَلَى مَا هَدَانَا لِدِينِهِ. We've sat down and we're calling Allah. So some people have an issue with people sitting down and making dhikr. Well, we have an issue with the Sahaba. And we're praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He guided us to His deen. This is the important part everybody has to remember. And this riwayah is in the Sunan of Imam al-Nasa'i. Sunan of Imam al-Nasa'i. And depending on what print and copy you have, the hadith number is 5330. Remember it. Because we have this issue all the time. Here is your hadith. And they said, وَمَنَّ عَلَيْنَا بِكَ. And we're thanking and praising Allah because He favored us with your presence.
SubhanAllah.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in response, he said, Allahi, ma ajlasakum illa dhalik. He said, do you take an oath that you've not sat here today except for this reason? They said, Allahi, ma ajlasana illa dhalik. They said, by Allah, we've not sit except for this purpose. To celebrate your presence and the deen you brought. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ama inni lam astahlifkum tuhmatan lakum." He said, "By Allah, I didn't take an oath from you because I doubt you. Wa innama atani Jibril alayhi salam fa akhbarani bi anna Allah 'azza wa jalla yubahi bikum al-malaika." He said, "I didn't take this oath because I doubt you. Rather, Jibril came to me and he informed me that Allah Azza wa Jal is boasting about you to the angels." If the Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala and their action is a cornerstone and evidence, then come and make mawlid every single day. Because the presence of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is through what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided you and created you. Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, when he had to forget from us, ate from that tree. And this is mentioned in Imam Al-Hakim's Mustadrak. And it's a sahih hadith on the conditions of Bukhari and Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said on the authority of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, لَمَّ اَقْتَرَفَ آدَمُ الْخَطِيئَةَ. When Adam alayhi salam fell into what he fell, he said, يَا رَبِّي بِحَقِّ مُحَمَّدٍ نَمَا غَفَرْتَ لِي. He said, Ya Allah, by the honor of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would you forgive me? This is because before Allah ta'ala created the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his physical form. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam, كَيْفَ عَرَفْتَ مُحَمَّدًا? How do you know Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? I've not created him physically. Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam said, لِأَنَّكَ لَمَّا خَلَقْتَنِي بِيَدِكَ وَنَفَخْتَ فِيَّ مِنْ رُوحِكَ رفعت رأسي ورأيت على قوام العرش مكتوبا لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله، وعلمت أنك لم تضف اسما إلى اسمك إلا أحب الخلق إليك. الله سبحانه وتعالى صدقت، لولا محمد لما خلقتك. He said, يا الله، when you created me and you breathed into me the life, I looked up and I saw on every single pillar of the arsh written لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. And I came to know with certainty you would not add anybody's name to your name except it's the most beloved of your creations. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, Adam, you've spoken the truth. Had it not been for him, I wouldn't have created you. If there's anything you need to take, it's increase in love for the Prophet of Allah alayhi wa sallam. You shouldn't be celebrating his presence and his existence just on Rabiul Noor, but it should be every moment of your life. And that's why we see some of the mashayikh in the Naqshbandi Tariqah. Their daily wabifa was over 70,000 salawat on the Prophet of Allah alayhi wa sallam. And when you ask them why, they say, because we are always in connection with the Prophet of Allah. This is lovely. To celebrate the Prophet of Allah's birth and his existence from Allah. And we finish with what Sayyidina Abbas radiallahu ta'ala said about the Prophet of Allah. He says, وَأَنْتَ لَمَّا وُلِدْتَ أَشْرَقَتِ الْأَرْضِ وَضَاعَتْ لَهُ الْأُفُقُ. He said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, when you were born, the earth became enlightened and the horizons were illuminated. فَنَحْنُ فِي ذَلِكَ الضِّيَاءِ وَالنُّورِ وَصُبُلِ الرَّشَادِ نَفْتَرِكُ. And we are on this path of light and illumination following your way to Jannah. Sayyidina Ali radiallahu ta'ala said, مَنْ رَآهُ بَدِيهَةً هَابَهُ. Whoever saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam without knowing him, he was overwhelmed by him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَمَنْ خَالَتَهُ مَعْرِفَةً أَحَبَّهُ. Whoever came to know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fell in love with him. مَا رَأَيْتُ أَحْسَنَ مِنْهُ لَا قَبْلَهُ وَلَا بَعْدَهُ. And I have never seen anyone better than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, neither before him or after him. وَأَخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ.